What's remarkable is that with just two components, we have managed to raise an immune response to a broad range of coronaviruses, including to viruses that aren't present in the vaccine itself. My name is Rory Hills. I'm a graduate student in Mark Howarth's group at the Department of Pharmacology, the University of Cambridge. So our group looks at engineering proteins. We take natural and design proteins and apply them to solve a wide range of different problems. A lot of our focus is on engineering proteins to solve human health issues. So for example, we've designed proteins that have been used in drug delivery, in cancer therapies, but a lot of my work is focused on trying to make better vaccines. To give some context to that, the development of the COVID-19 vaccines was a remarkable achievement for science and humanity as a whole. The speed and efficacy was incredible, but every one of us suffered through months and months of the pandemic when there was no vaccine. What our lab wants to do, what I want to do, is develop vaccines before the next pandemic. And this paper is a step towards that goal. So the paper is about our development of a new nanoparticle vaccine, and it has some unusual properties. In a conventional COVID-19 vaccine, you have a single antigen present. Now, an antigen is like the fingerprint of a virus. It's what we're trying to train the immune system to go after. In our vaccine, we have as many as 8 different antigens from 8 different viruses. These viruses can come from anywhere. Some of them come from bats, some from pangolin, but all of them have the potential to cross over to humans, as COVID-19 did. What happens when you take all of these antigens and put them on the same nanoparticle is you train the immune system to go after the parts of the antigen that are shared across the viruses. And so you get protection to all of these viruses, but also to related viruses, some of which we might not even know about yet, kind of like a predictive function. This vaccine is based on a protein nanocage that our group developed. It's essentially a ball of proteins that's held together by incredibly strong interactions. And then we use a technology called spycatcher, which is like protein superglue, to attach a chain of viral antigens to the ball. What's remarkable is with just two components, we're able to get a broad response to a wide range of coronaviruses, including to viruses that aren't present in the vaccine itself. And currently licensed technologies aren't able to do this. Beyond that, the major improvement in our vaccine is that we've made it simpler. Other vaccine technologies are able to accomplish similar breadth, but they require the production of extra proteins, and that makes it more difficult to scale and react rapidly. What we've done is streamline the production process, and so we're able to make things more cheaply and, most importantly, react quickly. I think this is an important step towards the idea of proactive vaccinology. We've shown that a relatively simple vaccine can still provide a scattershot response across a range of different viruses. And it takes us one step forward towards our goal of creating vaccines before a pandemic has even started. This was a remarkable collaboration, and a lot of people deserve a lot of credit. I'd like to particularly shout out Anthony Keeble, a senior postdoc in our lab who helped get the ball rolling with this project. Of course, my supervisor, Mark Howarth, who provided a lot of leadership as we brought this towards fruition. All of our collaborators at the University of Oxford, particularly Alan Townsend and Jack Tan, and also at Caltech, folks like Pamela Bjorkman and Alex Cohen, whose work was foundational to this study. Our lab has a variety of different protein engineering technologies that we're developing, all of which we're looking to apply to human health issues. If you want to read more about these or our vaccine work, I encourage you to check out our lab's website.